I am Vignesh and I'm coming from Government Victoria College, Palakkad.
All the very best to Vignesh and over to you. Alka.
Very distinguished panel of judges and my very dear friends, a very warm and extremely wonderful morning to all of you present here. I'm Alka Maria Simon. I'm doing my first year in the post-graduation of English Literature from St. Thomas College, Pala.
All the very best to Alka. Now for the motion, Vignesh, your 30 seconds starts right now, right here.
When you and I go to vote, we vote for a single party. We don't vote for a combination or a coalition. But our electoral system forces us to accept all the possible permutations and combinations with all the political parties that are contesting in the election. What it results in is a cocktail form of government where multiple ideologies are merging together and disappointing the voters. Now, let me ask you something. Here, if you are forming a government where a single party is allowed to form a government, here the leaders can work only for the nation. They will not have to favor or fear any other opposition or any other parties whose existence will...
Your time up, Talka. Your 30 seconds. Go ahead.
In this age, it's not about how operationally good you are, nor how tactically good you are. But if you cannot create harmony, you better go home, because leadership in that case becomes so obsolete. Just like the very famous literary question raised by Gayatri Chakravarti Spivak, can the subaltern speak? At some point of time, the real essence of democracy is dissent. Unless there's an amalgamation of the differing views in the democracy, when people are marginalized and you don't really find the voices heard and addressed, how can you say that it's democracy?
Thank you. Now, if you have 2 minutes, we've given 2 minutes for the debate and your time starts now.
Giving a single party with the maximum duty to form a government will ensure that we are having a clear leadership, we are having a clear vision. Not just that, it will ensure that we are having a strong opposition too. And independent candidates will no more be simple objects that are kept for that are kept for auction to cross majority mark. Don't you think this will empower the simple, smaller parties and also the independents?
Okay.
What we generally find is the idea that very often you have to mix things together. You need to have debates happening. When there's one single leader and all the other people flocking together with him, this is always one single idea. But you have several regional parties coming together. When there's a mixing of the ideas, we can come to a proper conclusion.
Okay.
Indeed, debates and discussions are very important, but we don't need those internal debates on internal discussions or those secret handshakes. What we need are clear visions and clear opposition to support those visions and to draw the limits for the party that is ruling.
Okay,
I would just like to bring to your kind notice the meaning of the Latin word, which means coalition, simply tells you that it's a growth together, it's a going together, which is a real essence of democracy. It brings in what is called the unity in diversity. When you have all these so-called stable governments with the maximum number of seats coming up, what we generally find is an autocratic government. What we find is that they generally become fascist in nature because there is no disagreement to the idea. So the understanding that democracy is challenged when you have this single party coming up.
Okay.
But the coalitions do have a problem. When I go as a voter to vote, I have a clear manifesto of each and every party. But if the coalition government is getting formed, there is a mixing of manifestos, mixing of ideas, and we can have contradictory ideas coming together. How is that possible?
All right.
I will just tell you that coalition governments in general brings centralization down to a federal structure. When we have a federal structure in the country, it's very often the mixing, it's very often the dissent, the kind of the mixing we have, the kind of different taste that we savor, and not just one American bowl of porridge, it's the thali that you have.
Okay, indeed, the federal structure is very important, but let me put it this way. If we are making the, it is mandatory.
And here, time up, thank you, contestants. Kindly switch your podium. 30 seconds starts now.
Alliances are, to be sure, very good, but forces of one zone are still better. I would just say political coalitions are like amoebas. They come, they shape, they regroup together. It's about forming new friends. It's about parting friendship with your old friends. So long before the Hollywood found the friends with benefits, I think coalition parties found that. So this is very often just lobbying and horse trading. Where is democracy in general? We are getting divided on the idea, aren't we? So the idea is to bring up one party with the maximum number of seats so that we'll bring in...
Against the motion, your 30 seconds starts now.
For a nation with so much of diversity, it will be absolutely undesirable to have a single party or a single ideology forming the government. What we need is a diverse form of government where coalitions are appreciated. Taking this idea into the fundamental levels, don't you think this might undermine the small regional parties? It will provide an unfavorable advantage to the big fishes in the Indian politics, and what will happen to the plight of the independent candidates? Will they mean anything anymore? What we need is a coalition form of government where there are proper checks and balances to every policy and program that is designed by this country, and that will only favor the growth for this country.
All right, thank you so much, contestants. Now, if you have 2 minutes for the debate, I'll start with you, Alka, and your time starts now.
I would bring to my friends very kind note is the fact that we have almost more than 2,000 regional parties in a country. So bringing them all together is kind of a mess. At some point of time, they bring all the regional issues together. So we get diverted from the national attention. What we find is that we have more important national procedures, maybe like gender issues or the economic factors. Bringing in all the religious things, bringing in what is known as your fight between each other is going to divide your attention.
Okay.
We can never think about applying all these kind of hypothetical Western ideas into this country because this is that diverse a country. We have been holding together for a long time just because we are diverse. And this diversity can only be represented if we are having coalition governments. And let me make one more point here. The very idea of democracy is to accept the others. If we are having this kind of a system, don't you think the party with the greatest majority will be over-glorified and the others will be dishonored?
Okay.
I would agree to what you said, but with some kind of difference, because at the point of time, when we try to take in the different voices from people, don't you think it brings in some kind of a loss in frequency? We cannot really pinpoint what the main problem is. We generally find it getting mixed up. We have it divided. So at some point of time, you cannot please everyone. And it ends up in pleasing no one.
Please, Vignesh.
Definitely, we are going to get a mixture of opinions. And that is why we are saying that we need a mix of leaders, a mix of people who can accommodate different ideas, a mixture of ideas to be the ones who are forming the government. Not a single person or a single idea to be running this country so that he might fail to accommodate all these different ideas.
The attention has to be brought to the fact that when you elect a person, it's generally about the majority. It's generally about the fact that people favor this group. The idea that maybe the 40% of the people of the country has favored one on the contrary to the other 60 is in one way or the other going to be the winning motive of this side. It simply tells you that this has an advantage over the other 60 because it was divided. This stood united and unity always wins.
Okay.
But the 60 are...